Hello, Brent Okeson here with the Trust. Going to show you today what a few good things look like at a ballpark, some of the best practices and things you might see. I'm going to walk you around and show you some of the key features of a really nice ballpark here. As you can see in the back here, it's good to have good access. Make sure you have good parking spaces and some really good walking paths, as you can see back here. And I'll take you out on the ballpark and show you some things that are great for preventing losses and liability issues. One of the things to look for is making sure you have good access for the public. This is a good example of a walking path. It's got plenty of space and it's a nice smooth surface. It's going to avoid trip hazards or any issues with that. Maintaining the grounds and the grass and the edges is all important, as well as keeping the trees trimmed up properly so that they're not overhanging or too low that people might walk into them. So this is a really good example of access and a good place for the public to walk into. One common thing that I often see at ballparks and other parks is these boxes in the ground. Sometimes they're raised too high or they're too low to the ground and they can become a trip hazard. And sometimes due to the mowing, these get torn up from the mowers and they can have holes and can become a real trip hazard for others. This is a good example of how to keep that flush to the ground, and especially in an open walking path where you have lots of grass and where people and kids might be running through. So a good example there. Here's an example of how to properly maintain a field. This one's just been recently raked out. It's in great condition, and you can see that it's managed in a way that makes it good for the players to play without anything else sticking out that could be an issue. There's been times where things are behind home plate, objects or things left back there that people can trip on. There's also looking at the fences. There could be bolts sticking out the wrong way or damaged components that you want to look for, but this is a great example of that. Another thing is the playground. They've got a netting over the top of the playground, which is great for the foul balls. Kids can play and not worry about getting hit in the head with a baseball. So that's a really good practice that they have there. As well as here in the dugout, it's important to look at dugouts and have them kept clean. This one has a nice cover over the top to provide shade. And the bench here is in great condition. Nothing sticking out that could hurt somebody or cut somebody or anything to trip on. So maintaining all of these are really important for managing a ballpark. One of the best things we see is the back supports and the railings across the back of these bleachers. This is great for the public when they come and watch the games. I've seen some that don't have these, and it's often a fear that children or other people on the back could slip off and fall off the back side. So this is really good to have these supports on the back and maintain the bleachers in a way that there's no missing end caps, that it's all in good condition with smooth surfaces and supported properly. So this is another great example. Another proper thing to all parks and playgrounds and even ballparks is having good signage. Having park rules posted up, as is the one here behind me. It's always important to let the public know what the rules are for the play areas. And you got to keep your spectators in mind, the public in mind, and also the players for their safety and liability concerns here. These are just some examples, and this concludes the training today.